Hello, my name is Abid Farooqui. I'm the president of Silverlight Aviation. We manufacture gyroplanes, two-seat modern gyroplanes in the United States. As far as I know, for this style of gyroplane, modern style, Juca style gyroplanes, we are the only manufacturer in the US. I started this company, Silverlight Aviation, in 2012 as a consulting company. And later on in 2015, 2016, got into gyroplane manufacturing. I started, I'm an immigrant originally from Pakistan to the US. I came to the US in 1989. I have three engineering degrees, microelectronics, mechanical engineering, computer science. So when I was growing up, I actually was interested in airplanes. At 12 years old, I had a little book that my oldest brother had given me that started from, you know, first airplane, 1903 Wright brothers, all the way to F-16. I actually slept with that book for about 4 years. Then I came to the US, I did my engineering, I got into flying, I got into trike flying, which is like a hang glider wing with weight shift control, as FAA calls that category. And I started a company called Tampa Bay Aerosport that later became Apollo Aircraft, and then Evolution Trikes or Evolution Aircraft. And we made a few different trikes, in first working with a European company and then completely in the US, Revo. And that company still exists. I sold out of it in 2012. But Larry, my ex-partner, who was partners with me in that company, still exists, actually at this very airport, at Zephyrhills Municipal Airport. And they are still doing trikes, and I moved on towards gyroplane. So I've worked on trikes, gyroplanes, trikes actually in the order of trikes, airplanes, and then gyroplanes. So before I ever went into gyroplanes, I had worked on manufacturing trikes, manufacturing airplanes, certifying them, consulted with other companies like American Legend, aircraft company in Texas, like Sea Ray, getting them type certification in China, getting them SLSA status in the US. So I did a bunch of consulting with 5-6 different companies, and then came into manufacturing into gyroplanes, because I saw gyroplanes as a unique aircraft that had a really bad reputation. And what I researched is the reputation that they had wasn't because of the necessarily inherent to the machine. It was somewhat design, a lot because of training, and a lot because the changes that were made to initial designs without considering other engineering factors. So this is kind of what happens when you have an amateur style community starting to design, and they don't take into account what happens when you just put a bigger engine on the same exact design. And because it's a bigger engine, they move the engine up, and then they use a bigger propeller, then the CG changes and all that stuff. So I thought that gyroplanes hold a lot of promise, because what happens in light aircraft is you fly light aircraft, and in thermals, in the midday conditions, you know, you get rocked around quite a lot because the wing loading is low. What's advantages about gyroplanes that I thought was that it has, if you remember when we were kids and we used to play with those gyroscopic effect with those toys, and as long as those are turning really fast, they remain very stable till they slow down, and then they kind of what we would call flap and fall down. So that turning has its own stability, and that's the principle the gyroplane uses. It's very stable. So even though it's a light aircraft, it has these blades which are very narrow, so the solidity ratio or the amount of area that is being covered by the wing is very small, and the blade loading is high, and because it's turning, it's very stable. No matter if you have thermals, no matter if you have gusty winds, it can handle those a lot better than a similarly sized airplane, which are limited by the wind, by the thermals. It's more uncomfortable flying them during midday. You have to fly them during the early mornings or in the evenings to be much enjoyable. So the utility value goes down. Gyroplanes solve that problem in a light aircraft. While you're a sport pilot in gyroplanes, you can still take advantage of flying pretty much at any time with reasonable weather. Thermals and stuff won't bother you as much. I started gyroplane design and manufacturing in 2015. 2016, mid-2016 is the first time we put a production machine out. So 60% of our customers are actually already general aviation private airplane pilots, sometimes commercial pilots, some of them are helicopter pilots. I would say airplane pilots are about 40%, 20% are helicopter pilots. So there's a mix. And then the rest of the 30% are really new people coming in that have never flown anything before. So it's a mix. But for sure, the largest segment of our customers are already pilots, either private pilot airplane or private pilot helicopter. And they are the ones coming in. And then some of them sport pilots in other categories and coming in and adding gyroplane and taking advantage of gyroplane's stability, gyroplane's maneuverability, and its steadiness in turbulent conditions. There are things an airplane pilot will have to kind of understand about gyroplanes and rotorcraft in general. They don't stall, there is no spin, okay? They are under control all the way, right? You can be behind the power curve and coming down, but you have full control. Unlike an airplane which stalls and starts to get out of control, you actually have control all the time. Even when you are behind the power curve and you are at 20 knots, you have control. You can push the nose down, you can bank left, right? So gyroplanes do hold that advantage. They're very safe in that regard. They're always in auto rotation. So engine has nothing to do with keeping you flying. They do not stall, like I said, and it's a rotary wing, and they can land at very, very slow speeds, like 5 miles an hour, even 0 miles an hour, technically, if you have perfect technique. So they are very good in that regard. The 10 to 12 hours is an average time for an airplane private pilot who is current, just because there are certain things like pushing the nose down in a gyroplane. You can do that. You have to understand the consequences of doing it abruptly, which would be unloading the rotor. What you don't want to do is you want to go to low G or zero G or negative G. You want to always keep loading under you, because the loading is what's driving the rotor and keeping it spinning. If you unload the rotor and you go to low G or towards zero G, the rotor will start unloading and slow down very, very quickly. And then you have rotor flap, which is blade stall, retreating blade stall. And that's where the problems happen. So as long as you're loaded, as long as you have positive G on you, the thing is spinning and there is no stall. So the stall is not dependent on a forward speed of the whole aircraft necessarily. Because these are not special light sport aircraft, so they cannot be factory provided, because FAA does not allow rotorcraft to be SLSA yet. They have actually excluded gyroplanes by name in the regs, which is kind of disturbing. But hopefully they'll catch up with the rest of the world, because in the rest of the world they are allowed, in Europe for example, and the safety is quite well proven for a modern style gyro design with tails on the back, right? So the pricing is of these type of gyroplanes, the kit pricing is in the 60s. So like a 100 horsepower kit will be around 65. By the time you're done, out the door type of price would be around mid 70s for, you know, radio equipped, transponder equipped gyroplane with dual controls with a 100 horsepower engine. So mid 60s all the way to 110 is our pricing range. It depends on the options you select, whether you want the enclosure or not, whether you want cabin heat or not with the enclosure, and so on, whether you want the bigger engine or the smaller engine. So the pricing will go, everything said and done, the real price, mid 70s to really like 105 or so. You can actually go to our website, www.silverlightaviation.com, and you can also visit us on Facebook, lots of information there. It is facebook.com/silverlightaviation.